Hello everybody and welcome back to No One Lives Forever. We're going to continue from where we left off. And this
Success
is where we left off.
Albeit overdue and underwhelming. Head to the war room for an update on the situation. Perhaps there is a shred of hope after all.
Okay. So we just have to report to the... to the yada yada yada. All right,
I can't believe this. She's late again. Where is that blasted girl?
Give her a break, Smithy.
About damn time.
There's been a new development.
I heard about the Monte Carlo incident. Was it harm?
Indeed. They've just issued their demands.
What you know is that at precisely
700
hours,
that's hella creepy.
On September 19th, 1967, an explosion destroyed Club Metropole in Monte Carlo, Monaco, killing 47 people and injuring more than 100. What you do not know is that the source of the blast was not a mechanical device, but rather a man, Commissioner Maurice Albert. Because you are at least somewhat familiar with the research of Dr. Otto Schenker, you are therefore capable of comprehending both the plausibility of this claim as well as its implications. As we have demonstrated, our organization, HARM, possesses the recipe for a biological weapon of such insidious potential and singular destructive power that no one on the planet is safe! Unless our demands are met.
This is outlandish.
By now, I'm sure Jesus. You have received the itemized list of our requirements. You have exactly 1 week to fulfill these requirements. If our demands are not met, we will be forced to discipline you. Already, we have infected prominent individuals in 36 major metropolitan areas around the world. The first of our unsuspecting victims will detonate at exactly 0600 hours on September 26th. The estimated death toll is 1 million people!
They're mad!
The remaining victims will detonate at 6-hour intervals thereafter. Once our terms have been met, we will deliver a list of infected persons, as well as a quantity of antidote sufficient to curtail this catastrophe. However, because the deadline we have imposed is dictated by the chemical fuse inherent in the reagent itself, the sooner you comply with our wishes, the more time you will have available in which to administer the antidote. I assure you that you do not possess the medical means necessary to diagnose the infection, nor the technical means necessary to defuse it. Therefore, it would be in your best interest not to squander valuable time on such useless endeavors. Furthermore, any attempts by your secret service organizations to interfere
this guy just smiling like a dumb
shall be severely punished. That is all.
A puppet?
Don't be fooled, messenger. This situation is extremely grave.
They certainly expect us to swallow a lot of maybes. Maybe they're telling the truth about Monte Carlo. Maybe the consequences would be as dire as they predict. Maybe there's an antidote. Maybe they'll fulfill their end of the bargain.
I tend to agree with you, Agent Archer. But for the time being, I suggest we take them at their word.
The word of a puppet?
What are their demands?
Mr. Smith?
£50 million, the continent of Australia. And an internationally recognized holiday to be known as Praise Be to Harm Day.
I don't see the point.
Presumably, it is to praise harm.
Not in the holiday. In their demands, if we aren't capable of fulfilling them, harm must want us to forfeit.
Nonsense. They may be madmen, but we have to presume they aren't completely irrational. Why even issue demands if their sole purpose were to cause destruction and chaos?
Perhaps they expect a partial capitulation. That way they can get what they really want, £50 million. But they can also be punishing us when we come up short on their other demands. It's obvious from the way they go on about their secret weapon that they're just itching to use it again.
You hardly have the experience necessary to support such speculations.
Archer may be onto something. In any case, Harm's motives are irrelevant. Our goal is to stop them. Completely. No capitulation, no compromise.
What about their warning?
Once again, we must take them at their word. It is therefore imperative that we act swiftly and decisively. Our objectives are clear. We must obtain the list of infected individuals. We must get our hands on the antidote, and we must recover Dr. Schenker.
And Volkov?
He's only a threat if he knows what we're up to. If our theories are correct about Agent Lowry, Volkov shouldn't be much of a concern.
What if your theories aren't correct?
Then may God help us all.
I hope we can come up with a better plan than that. What about the information we got off the ship?
Well, the containers you photographed weren't accounted for on the shipping manifest, which comes as little surprise. However, much of the cargo aboard the freighter was on its way to a chemical plant in southern England.
Not much to go on.
Be that as it may, it's better than sitting on our hands waiting to find out if Archer's correct about Harm's intentions.
And the captain's log?
Useless.
Shite.
Oh, I didn't know there was cursing in this game.
It's owned by Dumas Industrial Enterprises.
Dumas? As in Baron Archibald Dumas?
What do you know about him?
Only what I've read in the papers. Apparently, he's a reclusive chap, much of his time hunting big game in Africa and Southeast Asia. No one knows much about him except that he inherited the company from his father about 10 years ago.
We're counting on you to discover whether or not he's connected to Harm.
And if he is?
First things first. For now, try to get an audience with the man. Size him up. We need to know what sort of fellow we're dealing with.
Your best bet is to see if you can catch him at the chemical plant. There's also a corporate office up north, but apparently he doesn't spend much time there.
Whatever you do, don't jeopardize your cover. It's imperative that we take Harm by surprise.
Understood.
I have a hunch we're getting close. If this lead pays off, we'll be one important step closer to victory.
All right.
Welcome to Advanced Field Tactics. We've cooked up a stunning new perfume for you. It temporarily blinds and dazes anyone caught in its influence. Do be careful not to spray it upwind. This little fellow is one of our most refined.
Oh my God.
The P421 K9 Persuader. Just start it up with this convenient pull cord and set it on the ground. Using sophisticated olfactory sensors, the P421 will seek out the nearest dog within its range and release a cloud of pheromone gas designed to enamor canines of either sex. Quite useful for incapacitating bothersome guard dogs. Use your robotic poodle to distract the guard dog. Excellent.
That's it? Okay.
It is possible that the reclusive Baron Archibald Dumas is somehow connected to the disappearance of Dr. Schenker. It will be up to you and Agent Goodman to establish the link, if it even exists. The first step is to meet the Baron in person and size him up. Whatever you do, don't blow your cover.
Okay. Interview Baron. Search for evidence linking Baron to Harm. Okay.
Good morning. How may I help you?
We've an appointment with Baron Dumas.
I'm sorry, but are you sure it was today? The Baron usually reserves Mondays for golf. Tuesdays and Thursdays are for skeet shooting, Wednesdays for fishing, and Friday afternoons for backgammon.
Sounds like a busy schedule. How does he find time for appointments?
His lordship reserves Friday mornings between 11 and 11:15 a.m. for business matters.
Well, I'm positive today was the day.
Could you take another look at the appointment book?
I suppose, but I can't see that it will do any good. The Baron's routine is quite established.
There you go. Just like that, huh?
Would you excuse me for a moment?
You got diarrhea?
For about 10 minutes, poor lass.
All right, wait here just in case. I'll find the Baron's office and see if I can dig up some incriminating evidence.
I've got a better idea. You wait here and I'll snoop around.
No way, Sugar Pie. Remember what happened last time?
Heads or tails?
Tails.
Heads, you lose. Sugar Pie.
2 out of 3?
Don't be a sore loser.
Fine, but stay sharp. If you're seen, the mission's blown. If the Baron figures out you're in his office, the mission's blown. If you hurt anybody...
What? The mission's blown, I know.
Just remember what I said.
Okay.
I'm not sure I agree with your conclusion. Why not?
Whoa, what was that?
What's wrong with it?
How should I put this? Basically, you told your mother-in-law.
Well, somebody saw me already? Oh, the camera. Okay. God, so I have to wait for another loading screen.
I'm not sure I agree with your conclusion.
Why not? Well, your methodology seems a bit suspect.
Did you see
what's
what
wrong
she did with her hair? It's horrid.
Basically, you put your
I know. Short to spine. Look at Audrey Hepburn and Roman Horton.
Hey!
God damn it. Alright, let's try this again.
I'm not sure I agree with your conclusion.
Why not? Well, your methodology seems a bit suspect.
Did you see what she did with her hair? It's horrid.
Let's wait right here. Oh, another clue. Or intelligence item. Let's see. Oh, there's a camera right there. Oh shit. The camera's gonna look at me.
It's not
fuck.
Who's there?
Okay. Let's try the bathroom this time.
I'm not sure I agree with your conclusion.
Why not? Well, your method seems a bit suspect.
Did you see what she did with her hair? It's horrid.
Are you talking about Flora?
Yes.
Oh my god, this guy saw me. Oh wait, there's the camera right there too. Shit.
Look out!
Oh my god, come on, man. Okay. Oh shit, is that a guy over there? Fuck. Did I see? Or am I just seeing things? Jesus Christ, man.
Could you be a dear and dig up the latest accident report?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Oh, is this the guy?
What's the point of implementing safety regulations if no one abides by them? After 3 safety training courses in the past 2 months, you'd expect to see some decline in serious on-site accidents, don't you think? So would I. But according to this report, the accident rate has actually gone up.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir.
Somebody's certainly going to be sorry. Get hold of Mr. Manning for me, would you, dear?
Yes, sir. Mr. Manning is on the line, sir.
Thank you, Evelyn. Manning, this is Hilltop. Listen, I'm just looking over the...
What the hell? Do I have to wait for these people?
Hello? Manning? Good God, he hung up on me.
Shall I bring him again, sir?
Don't bother. I think I'd better have this conversation in person. I'll be back in a jiffy. Thank you, Evelyn.
Oh, shit. I keep pressing the wrong button. There's a camera there. Does it move?
Oh. She's over here.
Okay.
You look very nice today.
Thank you, Mr. Hilltop.
I'll be in my office if anybody calls for me.
Yes, sir.
I agree with your conclusion.
Did you see what she did with her hair?
Alright, guys. Finally know what to do.
Dear, and dig up the latest accident report.
Certainly, Mr.
Of implementing safety regulations if no one abides by them.
All right.
After three safety training courses in the past 2 months, you'd expect to see some decline in serious on-site accidents, don't you think?
I suppose so, sir.
So would I. But according to this report, the accident rate has actually gone up.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir.
Somebody's certainly going to be sorry. Get hold of Mr. Manning for me, would you, dear?
Yes, sir. Mr. Manning is on the line, sir.
Thank you, Evelyn. Manning, this is Hilltop. Listen, I'm just... pausing. Hello?
This is not his private office. I would assume this is his office. Oh, shit. Is that a camera? Thank you. Oops.
The Beatles?
Oh, shit.
Sure.
I wish they'd go on tour again.
Don't hold your breath.
Well, as long as they keep making records, I'm happy. I just hope they don't break up.
Who the hell wants to kill pandas?
Oh. Any luck?
Jesus Plenty. Christ.
Do you trust me now?
Nope.
Now then, let's see if, we can't sort this confusion out, shall we?
That's all right. Perhaps we can reschedule at a more convenient time.
So Certainly. How about Friday at 11 a.m.?
Perfect. See you then.
All right. Jesus Christ, that took forever. But we got it done.
I want to take a look around in there.
Good idea, but it's my turn.
Heads or tails?
Uh-uh. You got to go last time.
Heads or tails?
I'm going, you're staying. No arguments, no coin toss.
Don't be such a Jesse. Heads or tails?
Heads.
Tails. You lose. Again.
I'm in charge here. I give the orders, you take the orders.
Well, now that we've decided who's going in, what are your orders, sir?
All right. I'll help you get inside, but you'd better be careful. If anyone sees you, liquidate him before we can set off an alarm, and stay clear of security cameras.
Don't worry.
Photograph anything that looks suspicious and collect as much intelligence as you can. Files, correspondence, dossiers, anything.
Aye, aye, sir. Excellent orders, sir. I look forward to following them.
Okay.
Give me a few seconds, head start.
Okay. Easy enough, I guess. Infiltrate the chemical plant. Don't stop. Okay.
Was it any good?
Something about this Venusian society.
Oh, I saw that one. It was kind of weird. But they're all pretty weird, if you ask me.
True.
Oh my fucking god. Who saw me?
Was it any good?
Something about this Venusian society.
Oh, I saw that one. It was...
Thank you. quick breather here. Jesus Christ. Been holding my breath for like an hour. Finally know where everything's at now.
Yeah?
Then perhaps you know why it's not working.
You, didn't see my report?
So now I think the only thing that is...
I put it on your desk yesterday.
That's only a threat is, cameras.
The pump needed to be replaced. Is that the main process?
Go shut it down before the other half of the facility goes up in flames, will you?
Yes, sir.
And see if you can find out who turned it on and hold the bastard into my office. All
right, so this guy's gonna come out. He's gonna walk all the way over here. But you're gonna see the door open. I know exactly what everybody's gonna do now because I've died so much to this freaking level. So he's on his way. If you listen closely, you can hear his footsteps. Then we got his big boss man over here. Alright, here's the second one. There's a guy over here. He's gonna come over here. He can't really see us from this far away, and that camera can't see us from this far away. But if I start moving while he's like over in this direction, he'll hear a noise or something. He's gonna come over here, out of the sight of the camera, so I can shoot his face. Alright. So now we just gotta wait for the camera. Another guy up this ladder. And here's the third one. Okay, now what do? Continue deeper into the compound and search for additional evidence? Like what? Everybody's dead. Where the hell am I gonna go? Get a gun out just in case. I don't really know what they're looking for, but there's some stuff right here. I don't know what this is. It looks like a juice box. Or cigarettes, whatever. Poland, Kenya. What the fuck? What was that all about? Have to go in through that those doors over there or something. Oh. Oh, there we go. Fuck me, Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm gonna end it there, you guys. Ugh. Jesus. Okay, I'm going to leave a link in the description. Well, let's first save, and then we'll do that whole spiel. Okay, let's see.
Sergeant Magnus Armstrong. Well, well.
No. What the fuck? There. Save progress. Alright, 45%. Alright. So I'm gonna leave a link in the description where you can help out some dogs in Australia. Alright. So I'll see you guys later.